Soldier Rails in the city. We back outside. You already see what it is. You look behind me. Jersey is across the water. We're on mainland over here by the Hudson. Beautiful scenery, beautiful place to be, just to enjoy the outside of New York City in the summertime. The city is buzzing. It's Saturday once again. I keep on telling you, we outside, and it's always good when we outside. You know what I'm saying? Now, when I say we outside, I mean that. I always got this saying that says, you not outside unless you doing something productive. If you outside and you not doing anything productive with yourself, you committing crimes, you doing drugs, you doing anything to bring somebody down, you not outside. See, I always say that I'm outside because right now, look at me, I'm coming from work. You know what I'm saying? Even right now, we're working. We're doing this podcast, this vlog actually. So we outside, you know what I'm saying? Make sure you go up there and go check out the magazine once again at Bubble Shake Network, right? The Bubble Shake Network, I've published at least 3 magazines up there. I published Cuties for Inmates, which is 100 pages. I published Music Push Entertainment magazine. Hey, yo, you rappers, man. Yo, you stop being stupid. You got to utilize that magazine. Hit me up about getting in that magazine. I think we're probably like on the 4th issue. I stuck there for a little minute or whatever like that because Music Push Entertainment magazine is a huge project. It's a lot of write-up. It's not like Bubble Shake magazine, which, you know, of course, you know, I published Bubble Shake magazine. But it's a lot of... it's not like Bubble Shake magazine. Bubble Shake magazine, this is, you know, you got to put the interview, you interview the models, and it's a lot of work though. You know what I'm saying? Because you got to airbrush the models. You know, you got to take the photography. You've got to edit it. You got to edit that shit. You know what I'm saying? You know me, I put my hands on everything. I design everything. But make sure you go up there and go check out the magazine. I had to shout that out because I see that these other magazines out there talk about they got the best magazine out there, nigga. You know what I'm saying? You know what I mean? Which is all love, all jokes aside and everything like that. But you're not fucking with Bubble Shake magazine. Come on, man. You know what I'm saying? Bubble Shake magazine. Look, there's a star in front of you. You know what I'm saying? Right? There's, you know, there's music. There's beats. There's shows. There's vlogs. You know what I'm saying? We got everything over here. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, just a little joke competition with the guys. You're not the best magazine. Bubble Shake magazine is the best fucking magazine over here. You know what I'm saying? Shout out to all my dudes that's doing their thing though, you know what I'm saying? Or whatever, you know. You know what I'm saying? It's a competition thing, but it's all jokes because I published all of these guys, man. There's guys that I published inside of Bubble Shake magazine that never had a magazine, and now they got a magazine, they got a top magazine. Then there's guys that, you know what I'm saying, that's photographers or whatever, that felt a little ways about things. But, you know, that's how it is with these niggas. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know, you go and you do grimy shit to people or whatever like that, trying to take advantage of people. And you think that sometimes people are not going to get you back. You know what I'm saying? Or you think that they're not going to punish you for that shit or whatever like that. So, you know what I mean? You got to learn to keep the same energy with people. You know what I'm saying? You got to learn to keep the same energy with people. You know what I'm saying? And when you talk about people, make sure you always have something positive to say, even when they're down. Because you never know, you know what I'm saying, when that person is going to be back on top of a situation or any situation that they have going on. You know what I'm saying? And they're going to remember shit. All in all, though, make sure you go up there and go check out the Bubble Shake Network. You know what I'm saying? But now, you're now tuning in to Soldier Rails in the City on the WBE Network. Right? So, what's on the agenda for this week? It's the wrap-up for the week in hip-hop. Government affairs, you know, everything. There's a lot of shit that goes on out here that I see. But I know the one thing that was on the scale today, I mean, this week was, I seen that Nicki Minaj, everybody was big enough or talking about Nicki Minaj getting locked up for smoking some weed and shit like that. But it's fucking weed, man. It's drugs. All these hip hop, this is entertainment, you know. The drugs come and plays and play with it, you know what I'm saying? Some people can do drugs and party and have a good time and move on. And then there's certain people that can't just have just one, you know what I'm saying? They can't just have just one, and if it becomes a problem, you know what I'm saying, you have to go speak to somebody about it before it's too late. You know, shit like that happens, man. You know what I'm saying? I mean, it's weed. Niggas get locked up every day, B. It's New York City, nigga. You know what I'm saying? Especially if you come from the Giuliani era, where it's like, even the Giuliani era, it was like, I would be walking home and like pulled over by the detectives, three different sets of detectives in different precincts, like three times before I got home. I used to be like, damn, like, yo, y'all just searched me down a block. Why y'all searching me again? So, you know what I mean? When you in New York City or whatever like that, you get used to shit like that. Don't worry, Nikki. Nikki knows. Whatever, she'd be all right. But the major thing that we're here to talk about is the Donald Trump situation. I told y'all last week that, yo, Donald Trump was facing some real serious charges, right? You know what I'm saying? 34 counts of felony convictions, right? Of felony charges, actually. So what I gotta say about that is, all right, so let me keep it real. I really don't be into too many politics, because politics and religion is something that you really can't get in too in depth with people, because people have their own opinion when it comes to things like that. But in my opinion, I'm looking at it like, yeah, listen, man, you got Biden who done robbed the people, because he's under investigation. He's under investigation. You know what I'm saying? For stealing the money. Him and his son stealing money or whatever. Now, you know what I'm saying? You have Donald Trump on the investigation or whatever. You know what I'm saying? They took him to court for, what did these guys really do? I mean, they didn't blow shit up. They didn't commit espionage. They didn't sell guns and weapons to create mass destruction to people and people in their community. They didn't do nothing like that. You know what I'm saying? You're talking about business papers, man. When you doing business, everybody misses out on certain things in their business, that certain certificates or whatever things that they didn't do, or they was too busy and they didn't know about it. So, you know what I mean, then if he did do something, I mean, look at all the other shit that everybody else is doing. But I come to tell you this though, you know what I'm saying? The Donald Trump situation is very serious, because Donald Trump is a very powerful, powerful individual, bro. Because these guys that's in the government, you know what I'm saying, all of these politicians and shit like that, Donald Trump was the one that they was going to go get the money for their campaigns. You know, they come to Donald Trump, go get his campaigns. But Donald Trump not only did it over here, he also did it in other countries as well, right? You know what I'm saying? So now, you know what I'm saying, he built up the rapport and built up a relationship with these guys. You know what I'm saying? Now somebody else then took him out of there, and they have, you know, because, you know, they want a democratic state all over the world. You know what I'm saying? And everybody's not comfortable with that. And the one person that they was comfortable with, you know what I'm saying, these guys don't want him in office because he doesn't do things the same way that everybody else does it. So in the end, man, how I look at it is like, everybody wants to rule the, so now if you're saying that one side of the fence is not all the way right, and then another side of the fence is absolutely, you can see that they have their own issues. Then who are we supposed to trust? As the people. It comes out to where now it just seems like there should be an independent party, but they're not gonna make us get an independent party because there's only one thing in this new world order, and it's to take over the world. And I mean, the average man can see that nobody is able to take over the world. Even on a bigger scale, they can try, but you can't do that because all you can do is maintain the land. You don't own the land, you could just maintain the land. And when you're dead and gone, the land is still gonna be here. The same tree is gonna be there. The flowers is gonna be there. The same buildings, everything is gonna be there. You're not gonna be here because it's one thing that's given that the Lord has told you, and that you know that one day you're not gonna be here. As human beings, we all know that. As animals, mammals, every species all over the world. So Donald Trump look like he going to jail, nigga. They gonna lock his ass up. But then you guys gotta be prepared. Make sure you drink your juice, make sure you drink your water, you train, you work out, because shit is gonna get crazy out here. You know, what happens? Why does it seem like everything that people do out here, like you could be at the top of the game or top of a level or something like that, and they try to like crumble you and bring you down? I guess they got to bring you down to reality. But hey, listen, I can't put my fingers on it. Maybe you guys can put your fingers on it. You go down in the comment section below and you talk about it and tell me how you feel about it. So now the next time that we come up here, because this is going to be going on for a long time because the guy is still running for president. I don't know how. I've never seen no shit like this. A nigga is being convicted for 34 felonies. You know what I'm saying? It's going still, and it's leading in the polls. I've never seen anything like this. This is crazy. But in life, right? There's a first time for everything. That's what we're here to do, make history. With that said, you already know what it is, man. Leave your comments in the comment section. Soulja Rails in the city. We out here in the Hudson enjoying the boat rides and everything. I'm going to show you around. You have a good day. Peace.